Hi there, I'm Amina, and I am here with Zach, who is a junior in CS50. And Zach is going to tell us about his project called NeuroHub.
Hi, everybody. So my project is for neuroscience researchers to streamline their research and collaborate with peers. And so a major feature that you'll see on the homepage is this search function. So users can input any keyword they'd like. Let's say I wanted to search up the amygdala and search. And using an API that accesses a database through Springer, which is a very popular publisher, you get a search results page that populates with results from that search with amygdala in the keyword section of that database. And you can scroll through, and if there's an article that sticks out to you, then you can select it and add it to your library. And so these are the saved articles for each user. Another major feature on the homepage is that you can look at this image of the brain and click on different regions as you see fit. And so it will populate a page with information about that brain region as well as suggested reading. And you can do that for all of the lobes and the cerebellum. And then finally, one of the major features that I wanted to incorporate was the ability to interact with other users about different neuroscience topics. And so here you can go to the forums page and you can see existing forums as well as create your own. And so if I wanted to go into this topic, I could see that John has already left a comment and I can leave one of my own. So I can go in, add a comment and say, "So cool," and add it to the forum. And so this is something that dynamically updates as different users across the platform add their comments. And so those are a few of the key features of my website.
Wow, this is really, really cool. And it also seems that the build was actually quite intricate, right?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. So I'm curious to know, is there something that was intimidating about the build, but you know, you ended up surmounting?
Yeah, definitely. I think one of the most difficult parts was definitely getting the API up and running, because in the finance piece set, that was one of the major features, but it was done for us, you know, accessing the API and getting it and incorporating it into the project. So being able to do that on my own was definitely intimidating, but as soon as I hit the search button and got that page to show up for the first time, I was over the moon. So I'm very happy that
I definitely know the feeling.
Oh yeah.
Well, thank you so much for showing us your project today,
Zach. Thank you so much. Happy you.
Thank you. And this is CS50.